Let us discuss the partial filling of a dielectric in a capacitor. Say we are given with a parallel plate capacitor. We already discussed in the previous section about the calculation of its capacitance when dielectric slabs are filled in the plates parallel to these and completely filling the space. Now say if we consider a situation in which we fill partly the space between the plates with the help of a dielectric like this, and here the dielectric thickness is D and the total plate separation is D, then in this situation we can say that a distance D minus T is filled with air. It is not filled with dielectric, or it is the free space region. If the area of the plates of capacitor is A, then in this situation we can consider there are two dielectric slabs. One is with a dielectric constant K and other is with a dielectric constant K equal to 1. Because we know that the dielectric constant of free space is 1. So in this situation the equivalent capacitance across the terminals A and B we can write as epsilon naught A divided by T by K plus D minus T by 1. This was the relation we have studied for parallel filling of dielectric slab parallel to the plates of capacitor. So in this situation the capacitance across the terminals A and B for partial filling we can write it epsilon naught A divided by D plus T multiplied by 1 by K minus 1, or we can write D minus T 1 minus 1 by K. In either ways you can keep the result. So in this situation this is the capacitance which we are getting. One more important thing you can see here. If the dielectric slab is displaced from this side to this side, obviously the capacitance will remain same because the air space D minus T will be same, and rather on the right side of a slab it will be on the left side of a slab. Similarly, if we place this dielectric slab in between like this, say if it is the same capacitor we are using above between the terminals A and B, and if the same dielectric which is of thickness T is placed between the plates which is not adjoining to any of the plate, then also we can see if this separation is T and the region which is left over with the free space, total separation will be D minus T again, the sum of these two separations. So we can see the electric field which will exist in this region and in this region must remain same and the capacitor will be charged. So it won't make any difference on the potential difference across the plate as well as on the charge of the plate. So we can directly write down a note that due to partial filling, of a dielectric, between plates of a capacitor, and obviously we can write same area of plates. That means the area of dielectric has to be same as that of plates. Then capacitance of this system is independent from the position of slab between the plates. That means wherever the slab you place, whether on left side, on right side or anywhere in the middle of the two plates, we can say always the capacitance is given by this relation, or it can be written as epsilon naught A by D minus T 1 minus 1 by K. Either way you can calculate as one and same.